Hello everyone, my name is Ali and I am interior design instructor at Nifty Sphere Institute of Art and Design. So today in this video lecture, I am going to explain, demonstrate how you can make this cute little table inside 3ds Max and how you can render it, you can change the materials, you can apply the materials, you can place it inside your room. So I'm really excited to go with it, so let's get started. Yeah. All right. First of all, I'm going to open 3ds Max. This is how it looks like when you open it. I have the dimensions in my mind written on the side of the table, so I'm just going to start it. So first of all, you have to come here in this create panel, and after that, you have to click on the shapes. In the shapes, we'll select the rectangles. I'm in the top view right now. In the top view, you can see. It's the top right corner. It explains you in which view you are right now. So I'm in the top view. And the units. Let's get started with the units. Unit setup. I have the units in centimeters and centimeters. Perfect. So I'm going to start it from drawing a rectangle. I have dimensions in my mind. I told you, 45 by 45. Cool. So I am going to move it to the center. In order to move it to the center, I need to activate the move controls. I press W as a shortcut key. And now from the bottom, from this panel, you can see in which dimensions or axis this rectangle lies in. So let's just right click over here and make it to the center like this. Perfect. The next step, very easy, right click, convert to editable poly, sorry, editable spline, pardon me. Alright, we are in editable spline right now, and let's select the vertices. This is how you can select different objects. From here, you can select the vertices, segments, splines. So let's go with the vertices right now. I have just selected the vertices. All of the vertices. Okay, these grid guys are just making me feel bad because there's a lot going on here. So I'm just turning off the grid by pressing G over the keyboard. All right, they're gone. Excellent. So now we can fillet it. So to make the corner smooth, like you can see over there, they're very smooth corners. So I'm going to fillet. Sorry. Fillet them. Perfect. So make sure whenever you try this, you have all the corners selected. All right, I am going to fillet this now. Perfect. I think that's enough. That's more than enough. So let's keep watching how it's going. Yeah, perfect. So now the next thing is I am going to select the segments. Splines over here, I just clicked and selected everything. The next thing is I'm going to give it the outline of, okay, that's too much. Outline of 1 centimeter looks perfect. Now we are going to apply an extrude modifier. And once we apply the extrude modifier, let's add the value of 15. Let's see how does it look like. I'm pressing F3 to show the shaded view. All right, looks cool, but let's make it 20 maybe and see how it goes. I think 20 is more than enough, so yeah, 20 is okay. I'm just pressing F4 to see the edges. Looks good, perfect. The next step is I'm going to convert to editable poly. All right, select the edges. This edge and this edge, I have selected 4 edges on the right side and the 4 edges on the left side. You can see all the 4 are selected. I'm pressing connect. All right, that's dangerous. Let's not do it right now. Do it left first, connect, and then the right one first and the left one later on. All right, looks cool. And now let's move it to this side. So we have that opening. Yep, this part. All right. So I think the height is pretty much bigger than expected. So maybe we can select these vertices on this part and move it a little down. So we the height is pretty adjusted. All right, sounds good. Looks okay. Press G to hide the grid orb there. And now select the faces. Come to the top view again. Select all the faces over here. You see, I'm going to detach this because I'm going to make this part and this part separate. So I just selected these and I am going to detach them. Yep. Now just name it like backside. All right. And this one, this guy dude here is front side. So, all right. Looks good. All right. The next step is we are going to make this inside part, this guy here. So let's make it. Let's select. Right, I just selected all the edges from the left view and I just pressed connect. This is going to help us to create the inside part. Alright, I'm selecting it from the inside and I'm creating here a shape from the selection. I have selected the edges and now I am going to create shape from selection. Make sure you select the linear and make it inner part. Perfect. Inner part is selected. Now let's isolate it so everything else is hidden and we have only this part. Okay, cool. Now we have to complete this section because remember we disconnected that. So we have to do a little extra effort over here. Let's go to the selection. And in the selection part here, you have to mirror this guy. Alright, make it easy. And the y-axis. Boom. You see how easy it is? Alright, let's see what we can do here. We can move it this point here. Alright, move it closer. Alright, cool. So now we have two splines. This one is different, this one is different. So what we are going to do, we are going to attach them. So I selected this guy here, select this guy here and you will see attach. We have attached them. Okay, perfect. After attaching, we have to do one more step. Don't miss this. This is a very important step. Select the vertices. These two, since we attach them, they are not valid. We have attached them, but they are not valid. They are not a single piece. So just select them and click weld. Alright, boom. I think we are good to go. Yeah, now you can see they are connected as well. They are welded as well. Looks okay. Now we can finish the isolate and click extrude. Too much extrude. We want only 1 centimeter. And boom, we are good to go. Perfect. So let's see, where do we stand? Move it a little up. We are good with that. The next thing which I am going to do is let me think on it. Okay, cool. The next thing is let's close these holes. They don't look good. They are like ongoing stuff. So I'm just selecting the borders and cap. Cool. Select the borders. Cap. Everything is filled. We're good to go. And do the same with this separate part, the opening, the front one. Selected this, select borders, and press cap. We're good to go. Perfect. It's amazing. Next thing we on the z-axis. All right, perfect. Just make sure you have a copy of it, make it isolate, extrude it amount, like, let's make it 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, let's try 10, and see if we don't cross the limits. Yes, this looks really good. The next step is, edit poly, select the face, and press inset. That's gonna help us to make pocket, make the drawer area, and now we are going to extrude it inside. Perfect. Looks so smooth. This is so easy. And let's see. Alright, we have to extend this a little bit. But before we extend it, I think I made this guy a little longer than it should be. So I'm just selecting the vertices and moving it slightly down. Alright, looks good. Now move it a little upward. Perfect. I press copy again and select the vertices F3, and I am going to expand it to here. All right. Looks good. I'm just going to move Gizmo. This is what you see over here is called Gizmo. Moving it to the center to the object, and boom, yep, looks good. One more thing, let's move this dude here a little bit upward. All right. Looks much better. And now we are going to make the legs and this part. All right, it's not gonna take longer, so it's gonna be quick, I promise. Come to the edit poly, select this part, make sure you isolate it. And now you select this edge. I press double click, so all the edge to this corner is selected. And now you have to press create shape from selection. Let's call it pipe. All right, looks good. Now I deselected everything, and I'm very carefully clicking on the line I just made. All right, looks good. Come to the rendering, enable in render, enable in viewport, and yeah, the pipe is ready and looks really good. Let's make it a little bit bigger, 1.5. All right, this looks amazing, and we have to do the same thing with the front part. Now you see in front we don't have the edges, so no worries, we can add the edges by connecting the edges. I just select front view, select the edges, click all the edges you want, and click to the connect. Perfect. So right now, just double click again over here, but we don't want the inside part, we only want outside part. So what we can do here is we can simply deselect, or we can select this guy here and this guy here, sorry, this guy and this guy here, and simply press control backspace. So we disconnect the connection between front and back. Next thing which I'm gonna do is just select this guy here and create shape from selection. All right, perfect, looks really good. The next thing which is interesting one is the legs part. So what we are going to do with the legs is we can simply just right click convert to edit poly, select faces. All right, sorry, I did the wrong thing. Select this guy here, and we have to be a little careful. Convert to edit poly and select the faces. I select these faces and detach as a clone. I would say it legs. All right, it's good. Now I select the leg Yes, we are detached and move it a little down. Perfect. I'm going to rotate it. Before you rotate it, let's make pivot center the object. And we rotate it. All right. This looks really amazing and quick. All right. Let's move this a bit up here. All right, look good to me. So the one thing which doesn't look good that we added in the front, it should be actually in the back side. All right, yeah, at this place. Looks cool. Here. All right, looks good. All right, looks good to me. Now I have to copy the same on the left side as well. This place, I'm just pressing shift and dragging it, and it makes the copy. All right. All right. Looks good to me. Same way, let's move it to the right side as well. I just copied. All right, looks perfect. So we got three legs. Okay, this one should be a little up on the front side. Sorry. Move it to the front side, and here we are. Looks cool. One more thing which I want to do is just make a leg, make one leg or one support in the bottom. Okay, I just copied it, move it to the 90 degrees, and let's extend it up to the other end. Yeah, I just selected it. Right, not cool. Selected it. Perfect. Everything seems good. Now we are going to just save it and render it to see how does it looks like. Just press Control S and let's. Before saving, let's do one quick thing. I'm just going to group it to name table. Alright. Right click, convert to item poly. Alright. Now I'm going to save it to, let's say, my favorite folder where I have all the stuff going on. Table NIFTY. Alright. Perfect. Now we are going to place it. And we are going to check a couple of different, you can say, materials and see how does they look like. So let me open one of my recent scenes over here. Let's try with that one. All right, let's go with the scene 20. Yep. Alright, I have this scene over here, so maybe we can move it to this side and we can place the table near this place and see how does this look like. So I'm going to import, merge, and let's see what we have here. Where did we save it in the downloads? Yeah. Alright, select all and okay. So we have the table here, let's move it and do a little placement. Let's see, I'm just moving it here. Maybe let's put a couple of things on it. See how does this looks like. Maybe this table guy here, I'm going to detach it from the other one and move it to this part here. Okay. Okay, looks good. All right, so the next thing is we are going to apply the materials. I will be making the material. It's gonna be really quick, but I just scaled down the plant because it was looking too much. And let's see, okay, it's this corner. Move it a little up maybe. Yep, move it a little up. And here we go. Boom. I think we are set with the table. Just have to apply a couple of materials. So what I'm going to do is, okay, just throw this guy here. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just make a material. Okay, first I want to isolate it. Done. I want to apply this material which I have already over here, but maybe let's make it really quick so you have an idea how to make a material inside 3ds Max. Okay, let's make a material inside 3ds Max. Alright, make it the reference should be 0.25, 0.35 maybe. Cool. Next thing, I'm just going to open the group, Control Shift O, select this dude, this dude, this dude, this dude, and this boy here, and that back as well, and apply this material to the legs. Perfect, really good. Now at this panel, we can try different. Okay, first of all, we select this guy here, this guy, and let's apply our default material. It should be a neutral color, not more. No more sharp color or no more dark color. So looks really good, man. The next part is we are gonna make a material here, and in this part corona color, and I'm gonna change the color to, let's say, a little pinkish as we have in the reference, and then we can see if we can, if we want to change or if we want to have any other input in it. All right, make it a little darker. Double click in, make the roughness up 0.45, and let's apply it. Boom, good. Did I make a mistake? No, cool. The next thing is we are going to see how actually it looks like. So, and later on we can change the you can say material. So let's 3, 2, 1, let's render it and see how does it look like. All right, come on. Right, a couple of things which I want to adjust. Actually, in the reference, although the legs seems to be very small and tiny, but I think in our scenario we can increase the size of the legs and a little bit height of this overall, so it will look like it will adjust with the scene in a better way. So let me do that, and then I think we should change the color from pink to this part, so it should have a balance, or maybe blue part. So just remember one thing, don't use too many colors in one scene. If you are giving the eyes of users to focus on 5 different things, user is going to get confused. Make sure don't give too many colors in one screen, only 3, maximum 3, not more than that. So if you talk here, you can see 1 color, 2, and 3. The rest of them are just colors, they are not additional colors. So we are going to change this as well. Maybe blue, or maybe this wall color which we have over here. So first we need to adjust the height of this table. I'm just going to open the group and move it down a little bit. All right, perfect. All right, and then this one too. So I think we are all good with this. The last thing which we want to do is just increase the height of this pink boy here. He will no longer be pink once we change the colors, which we are going to do soon. All right, perfect. The next thing, change the color of the back side as well. Select the vertices and let's move it and snap. All good, perfect. I think that was easy and quick. Let's see where we get. Okay, now the next thing is we are going to move it a little up to the floor. And here we see. All right, let's try the blue color. How does it look like? Give me a second and let's see. Okay, this is the base color. Boom, 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 boom. We want to see. All right. So, man, you should be. All right, it was color correct and then it was blue. So we have to change the color. Let me check it. Okay, 1 minute. I'm just going to select the material. Okay, here we are. And changing the color from pink to blue. Kind of like to match the same pink as we have on these cushions, so that doesn't look too different. You don't give too much eyes to the to user, so which point to focus the eyes of user. So let's see how fine it looks like. I think this is much better. It's going to take a couple of seconds and then you can see like how does it look like finally. Maybe we can zoom that part and render only that, so it would be really quick. Alright, I think the things are pretty clear now. Yeah, now our scenes look fantastic, I think. And if we do a couple of other adjustments, I think we are going to make a good difference. Yeah, I think this looks really good. Let's see if we increase the environment to 2. Alright, perfect. Let's adjust a couple of other things. 3. Yes, now it looks really good. So this is how quickly and easily you can make any 3D model object and you can place inside your whole scene and you can render it. I hope to see you in the next video. Till then, see you. Tata, bye bye.